Labą dieną. Yesterday was a long day, but at least I have all the packs prepared. Now they are crisp, smooth. The problem is that the edges are rather sharp. So I have to knock this off, and doing this by hand will take me forever. I calculated that it's about close to 400 meters of edge to sand, so yeah. I would like to speed up this process. And I had this problem last year when I was making a batch of easels. So I bought a router bit with very tiny radius just for knocking the edges. So let's put that router bit into the table and cue the time lapse. So this pile of sticks are in perfect condition, and this is the pile of not so perfect, but they are very close to that. And as you can see, I'm still missing some, so let's fix these to meet the standard. Finally, I have all the packs plus two, and also I have an emergency pile which I can quickly fix up and use if needed. So now it's time to trim these to length and set them in the frame. But first of all, I need one crucial task to do. Let me show you. Look at this mess. Look at this mess. Look at this mess. You can call it a waste of time, but I can't work like that. I need a quick cleanup. Not gonna lie, I took my time with cleanup, but honestly, I try to do a thorough cleanup at least once a week, so I suppose I can put a check mark on this one. But the problem is that my project haven't moved much today, so let's get back to it. Just right. Whenever possible, I check the measurement in place, and I try to avoid those measuring tools as much as possible, because that's just an extra possibility for making a mistake. All of the pegs are cut to length. I found four more pieces which needed some filling. And by the way, the number one time saver in this case is CA glue. It's really great for those tiny fixes. Anyhow, now I have to think of some smart system of fixing these onto those cross members. A few ideas running through my mind, but I think I shouldn't overcomplicate the process and just drive a screw through the cross member into the peg. The only concern I have that both of the screws will end up more or less in the center of the peg, and it will be very easy to turn it. So my idea is to shoot a couple of brad nails, trim the heads off, leaving only like a millimeter of exposed nail, and once I will drive the screw in, these nails will bind with the wood and prevent it from spinning. But that's just a theory, so let's test it out. I did a quick test piece and it just confirms my suspicion. It's fairly easy to twist the peg. So let's try my solution. to my colleague's workshop to take back the nail gun, he suggested to just add a dab of construction adhesive under the pack and drive in the screw. So I guess let's test both of these solutions because I'm not really sure which one works better. So while the test piece is setting, it's a great time to play a bit with peg layout. At the beginning, architect had these two options in mind and she settled with this one, also leaving me a bit of a wiggle room to adjust the design if needed. So it looks great on a drawing, but there's one problem, these two meeting corners. There's basically no chance these corners gonna meet throughout the whole length of the peg. So that's why I created a bit of a gap in between the pegs to hide all the imperfections. Also, I had to bring the pegs closer together because visually this gap looked way bigger than this one. So yeah, this is the design we are going with. Let me explain what was I doing. So first of all, I glued a few peg offcuts in the exact spacing of the pattern just to see if it looks okay. And once I was satisfied, I copied the same spacing all the way till the end of the cross member just to double check if the spacing at the end is also correct. And it was. Kind of, but close enough. Then I made this hole drilling template just to reduce any kind of error. Now I just have to place it on the stick, position it in the middle, and I'm good to go. Then I made this pilot hole jig. It goes on the end of the peg and I don't have to measure anything, and I just drill a hole exactly in the middle of the peg. And lastly, I made this peg positioning jig. So it has the exact spacing from the edge and in between the pegs. Hopefully I'm not gonna need it, because if these holes in the pegs and holes in the these cross members will be in the correct position, the peg should line nicely. But you never know, so I'm prepared. Yeah, but it's 10:08. PM, so I'm not gonna start anything today because, like I said before, I tend not to do any crucial tasks at the end of the day. So I will do this layout tomorrow in the morning with fresh head and a cup of coffee. So it should go better. I'm really eager to try this thing out, but I checked if the glue is set on the other sample, so it's not. So it also has to wait for tomorrow. So yeah, that's all I have now. Sincerely, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.